we have another condition here where the pump does not produce the rated flow or head. And so the conditions around this again would be that the pump is operating, you know, that the motor is rotating, that the pump is rotating, you know, that the discharge and suction valves are open again. And in this scenario, there is fluid that's flowing through the system, but the flow rate or the head in the system is below the rated condition. And so in this case, you know, you're getting fluid flow, but it's not meeting the system requirements in terms of flow or head. And so there's a few different causes that could contribute to this. One would be that you have an air leak through a gasket. And so this could be a gasket on your piping or right at your suction flange, or potentially even a gasket in the pump itself where you may be sucking air in to the suction line. And if you are sucking air in, you're now displacing some air along with your fluid, and pumps are not extremely efficient at pumping air or a gas. And so you can see a reduction in pump performance because of entrained air in the fluid. You can also get air that couldn't be sucked through the stuffing box. And this can happen if you have an insufficient differential head in the system, or the inlet pressure is extremely low, so we're not building up enough pressure in the seal chamber. And so, or potentially the mechanical seal has failed. And so in this case, you need to inspect your seal, whether it's packing or mechanical seal. And then you can resolve this typically by adding some sort of a pressurized flush system to the seal chamber. This could be a plan 11 flush, or where you're taking high pressure fluid from the discharge of the pump and pumping it back into your seal chamber. And there's a variety of other options here. But if you are getting air sucked in through a stuffing box, you can actually get a reduction in flow. Again, you're starting to displace air rather than fluid, and pumps are not going to be extremely efficient at that. Similar obstruction could occur within the impeller. And so if you have a partially clogged impeller, then yeah, you may have reduced performance. Now, this would typically be coupled with a vibration issue. And so if you have a partially obstructed impeller, you'll typically see excessive vibration occurring. And that could be a symptom of a partially blocked impeller. Another one, particularly for semi-open impellers, is that you may have excessive impeller clearance. And so on these pumps, you're typically going to have the ability to adjust the impeller clearance, and that's typically external and near the power frame. And so if the clearance has been set too high or too great, then you're going to get a lot of slip inside the pump, and you're going to see a reduction in the performance around there. Additionally, you could have inadequate suction head. And so this is associated with NPSH available of the system. And if you have inadequate or insufficient NPSH available in the system, then you could be seeing cavitation occur that would be reducing the pump's performance. And then finally, you may have some sort of extra wear or damage inside the pump. The first area that you would check would be the impeller, and inspect and make sure that the impeller is in good condition to be able to support performance that's expected. There's other things outside this that could contribute to insufficient lower head, And that could be that the impeller is sized incorrectly for the condition of service. And so it's possible that the impeller trim has been over-trimmed, or potentially the pump RPM is not at the rated RPM, and you can see a reduction in flow because of that as well.